my hotel, sitting on my bed. I said, let me clear my pockets. I take this out and I read, Allah Muhammad, Abbana, Abbana, something of Rabbana, Atina, Fid Dunya, Hasanatan. You see, the human mind works like that. You get a start, and you think what is there. It's not there, but you think in your mind. And I turn them the other side, and he tells me the Lord's Prayer. I said, the Lord's Prayer? In Pakistan? I said, the Pakistan is doing this beautiful thing. They beat me. I have done some beautiful works. But I said, hey, the Pakistani put me to shame. And there's nothing wrong with that. Allah Bari Ta'ala wants us to compete with one another in good works. He said, وَلِكُلِّمْ وَجْهَةٌ هُوَ مُوَلِّيهَا فَاسْتَبِكُ الْخَيْرَاتِ and compete with one another in good works. I said, the Pakistanis beat me. I was happy. They beat me. But it says, the Lord's Prayer. I said, we don't talk like that. What do you mean Lord's Prayer? So I told again. He says, Abbana, Abbana. It's not Rabbana, it's Abbana. Ah! O our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy King. This is the Christian prayer. O our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth. They're catching fish. They're catching Muslim fish. And a Saudi old man like me, I don't know, take his name, in Jeddah, I show him. I said, Akhi, this was given to him, to me. Look at this. He said, Allah Muhammad. I said, no, Ya Sheikh, have another good look. He said, Allah Muhammad. I said, Ya Sheikh, please, have a good look. You know what it is? Allah Muhabbah. But it looks like Allah Muhammad. Every Muslim who gets it, kiss it, put it on the wall, Allah Muhammad, what a beautiful Torah. Catching fish, deceit, deceiving the Muslims and catching fish, getting them towards Christianity.
وكنت مرة في الباكستان وبعد أن وجدت نجاحا كبيرا وجاء الناس يصافحونني تقدم مني صبي صغير في 12 تقريبا من عمره وقدم هذه النشرات والكتيبات وفي ظاهرها تبين كأنها الله محمد فلم تكن عندي لم يكن عندي الوقت للاطلاع عليها وضعته في جيبي وعندما عدت إلى دبي تصفحتها وقلبت الجهة الأخرى وجدت أنها بها كلاما ليس من الإسلام وعندما ذهبت إلى جدة وعرضتها على رجل كبير السن فقال انظر أيها الشيخ مرة ثانية بشكل جيد قلت له هذه الله محمد قال انظر إليها مرة ثانية فوجدت أنه المكتوب هنا الله محبة وليست الله محمد ولكنها مكتوبة بطريقة لأول نظرة تظهر كأن الله محمد فيقبلها المسلم ويأخذها إلى بيته وربما لا يدقق النظر مرة ليرى أن المقصود منها هو اصطياد المسلمين كما يصطاد السمك وأن يغشوا ويخدعوا بهذه الطريقة.
These are small pieces. Something bigger. Look at this. Look at this. Look at this. I was telling my Saudi brethren in Saudi Arabia, I said, if the Saudi government gives me permission to distribute this to the Hajis, I can sell 1 million copies of this at a rial each, at least. At a rial each. Every Haji will buy 5, 10, 50 to take it back home to give to his people. Look at this. You know what this is? You know what this is? This is Christian deceit. Catching Muslim fish. All this is Christianity. Have you ever seen things like this before? Have you seen it? This. No, this is how they catch fish. Now when we complain, it's a look. I believe in a fair fight. A dialogue. Allah wants us to have a dialogue with them. A fair dialogue. Allah tells us to tell them, pull, tell them, Ya Ahl al-Kitab, O people of the book, O Jews and Christians, Ta'alaw, come, ila kalimatin sawa'in baynana wa baynakum, that we come to common terms, as between us and you. Let us get onto a common platform. Let us have a discussion, a dialogue. Allah wants us to have a dialogue with them. But we haven't done it.
وهذه أيضا أشياء أكبر من الأولى ولو بيعت مثلا في السعودية للحجاج واشترى الواحد واحدة أو أربعة أو خمسة بريال للواحدة لنشرت في بين ملايين المسلمين وهي أيضا طرق أخرى لخداع المسلمين من قبل المسيحيين ونحن نقول دائما لنتحاور ليكون الحوار العادل بيننا وبينكم كما يأمر به قرآننا العظيم
Allah wants us to have a dialogue with them. we have stopped doing dialogue. For more than 1,000 years, we haven't done it. Now the Christians want to have a dialogue with you. His Holiness, the Pope, Baba, you call him Baba, he went to Turkey. And when he went to Turkey, he said, we must have a dialogue with the Muslims. When he went to Nigeria, he proclaimed, we must have a dialogue with the Muslims. When he went to Kenya, he said, we must have a dialogue with the Muslims. Wherever he goes, he's talking about having a dialogue with the Muslims.
أينما يذهب البابا يقول أنهم يريدون حوارا مع المسلمين. قالها في نيجيريا وفي بلاد تركيا وبلاد أخرى. ويبدو الآن أنهم ينشرون هذا الكلام يقولون نريد حوارا مع المسلمين.
I was waiting for some sheikhs, some mulvis, some maulanas, you know, learned people of Islam, to go along and have a dialogue with him. I was waiting and waiting and waiting for years, wanting somebody to do the job. Because in my heart and mind, I'm not a learned fellow, wallah. You know, I didn't go to any Darul Uloom. And even this English education, what I'm talking, I don't want to tell you what standard I passed, because my son told me that if I ever tell people, he said he'll walk out of the meeting. Fortunately, today he's not here. He's in the hotel, he's not too well. Pray for him.
لقد انتظرت طويلا ليهب عدد من المشايخ والعلماء المسلمين ليذهبوا لمحاورة البابا فأنا في هناك في منهاتن لست بالقادر تماما على أن أقوم بهذه المهمة لأنني لم أدرس في دار العلوم مثلا ولا في مراكز إسلامية عريقة كما درس علماء آخرون كنت أتوقع أن يهبوا ليبدأوا هذا الحوار وقد انتظرت طويلا لذلك
Seeing nobody wants to take him on, I said, all right, let me accept his invitation. So I wrote a letter to him. I said, Your Holiness, the Bible says, come, let us reason together. Let's have a dialogue. The Quran says, tells me, come, Ahl al-Kitab, ta'alaw, ila kalimatin sabayim baynana wa baynakum. So I said, now I accept your offer and I'm prepared to come over to the Vatican in Rome, any day, any time, you tell me, I'm prepared to come. Tell me when.
وعندما وجدت أنه لم يتقدم أحد نهضت لهذه المهمة وأرسلت رسالة إلى البابا أطلب منه أن يحدد الزمان والمكان وأنا على استعداد أن أذهب إلى الفاتيكان لأن الإنجيل كما ذكرت له يطلب هذا الحوار والقرآن يأمرنا ربنا فيه بأن نقوم بهذا الحوار مع المسيحيين وغيرهم
So no reply came. So I sent another letter. No reply came. I sent a telegram. No reply. I sent another telegram. So comes the response.
لم أتلقى ردا على الرسالة الأولى فأرسلت غيرها ولا رد ثم أرسلت برقية ولا رد وأرسلت برقية أخرى ولا رد ثم أرسلت برة أخرى.
Comes the response.
ثم جاء الرد.
That is prepared to receive me in his private secretariat in the Vatican.
بأنه على استعداد لمقابلتي في سكرتاريته الخاصة في الفاتيكان.
I write back to him. I said, Your Holiness, how big is your secretariat? Because from South Africa, my young men, three plane loads of youth want to come along to that dialogue. Three plane loads from Durban, Johannesburg, and Cape Town. My friends in the UAE, they want to come along, and the whole world will be interested. The Christians number 1,200 million, 1,200,000 Christians. The Muslims are 1 billion, 100,000 Muslims. I said between these two, more than 2 billion people would be interested in this dialogue. And the TV networks of the world will want to cover it. The news media wants to cover it. How big is your secretariat?
وقد سألته كم هو اتساع ذلك المكان؟ لأن الكثيرين جدا يريدون الحضور معي لهذا الاستماع لهذا الحوار وهناك 1,200 مليون مسيحي يهمهم هذا الحوار وألف مليون مسلم أيضا من كل بقاع العالم فما هو حجم هذا المكان الذي سنتحاور فيه
So another letter goes, a telegram goes, no response.
وهناك رسالة وبرقية أخرى أرسلت ولا رد عليهما
Until this thing comes. This picture here comes in the post. His Holiness plays hide and seek with Muslims. You know, people play the game, little children play hide and seek. You know, they hide away and you go and search them out.
يبدو أن نيافة البابا